Hello, everybody.
Hi, guys. Thank you so much for being with us today for Live with Lee and Hayley. I'm Hayley Harmon. This is Lee Cruz. We appreciate you being with us on this Monday.
Oh, big show. Mm-hmm. A lot of fun today's show. We're talking with a young man, a courageous young man, who's we're going to learn a little bit about what he's going through with juvenile arthritis. Ollie is going to be here to talk about his story.
Yes, not my dog. It's a little boy named Ollie.
Yeah, Ollie.
Yeah, so we are so excited. I love him already because his name is Ollie. So it's this awesome kid, from Northern Kentucky, and he's going to teach us a little bit about juvenile arthritis because it's something you probably have heard of. I know we have, but we're just going to kind of learn more about the experience and how it's affecting people right here in Kentucky. So we're going to get to chat with Ollie. We're so glad to have him with us. And also, we're going to be doing a little auditioning today. For fame.
We're going to blow this popsicle stand.
That's right. We're done.
We're going to get a gig in Pigeon Forge.
We sure are. Or Piggy on Forge, as some say.
Yeah. Some do.
They have a new competition. It's called The Path to Fame. And we're going to chat about that today. And we're going to do a little auditioning and tell you all about that and kind of what that means. So we're going to do that. So how was your weekend? We missed you on Friday. You were gone for a boys' golf weekend.
I had a boys', you know what? I should have did this properly. I could show you a photo of me and the boys. So get ready there. That's my bracket that's busted.
Oh my gosh, my bracket is all red.
I don't know if you can see this or not. Blow that up a little bit.
The dudes.
See, there's the boy. We got one guy's got a huge head.
Yeah, look at that. He's not
massive head.
No.
Yeah. These are mostly thugs and criminals.
That's right.
But we had such a good time. The weather was great, but we had never done it in March before.
And you were at Dale Hollow.
Dale Hollow, yeah. We went down to Dale Hollow and said, oh, by the way, Ron.
Ron.
Wanted me to make sure I tell you and Catherine hi. Will you say, he said like five times, will you say hi to those girls for me? Yes, Ron,
we had so
I will.
Much fun with him, our producer Catherine and I, and Lee as well, but he seemed to give me and Catherine more attention.
Yes, he did.
When we went down there, we did our live show, and he's the pro.
He's the pro. He runs the pro shop.
And he can give you lessons and stuff, and he was really, really sweet. So what's up to him?
But it was perfect because we could play golf, and then we could just watch basketball nonstop.
Which
and
is what I did all weekend. I literally did nothing else.
And our beloved Kentucky Wildcats
making
advanced.
A sweat.
I knew that Wofford team was tough, though.
Those threes. Well, not from the one guy that made all the threes prior to that
something.
Game.
I want to tell you something right now. Let me tell you something. Coach Cal's brilliant. That's why we won that game. Because
that's
what they did in the old basketball vernacular I would use, it's almost like a box and chaser. So Tyler Hero was obviously assigned to the kid who
big fan. You're a big fan of his.
Set the freaking NCAA record for most threes ever made, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So Tyler, it's his job.
Is it McGee? McGee?
Yeah. Fletcher McGee.
Okay.
So it's he had to stay on that kid. But what he also had going on at the same time was Nick Richards was sort of just around the bottom of the
floating around.
Anytime kid here comes 7 foot wingspan at you, and the kid can say, well, it was the same defense we saw in the Southern Conference. No, it ain't. You were changing the trajectory of your shot because we were hunting you.
Ha-ha!
Good job, coach.
So, Kentucky advances to the Sweet 16. My Tennessee Vols advanced, but
barely.
Had to go into overtime. What was that about? Why are we doing this? Yeah. You were up 25. Let's not do this.
And then, of course, we all saw the cosmic karma that is chaos when evil seems to prevail too often, as Duke won. Against those Central Florida kids and my man Taco.
I couldn't believe it. I like screaming, and I think all of America was screaming at their televisions when the shot went up and it didn't go in, and then the putback didn't go in. How in the heck does always get on the side of luck?
Those privileged kids from Duke caught a break.
Thank goodness they needed it. Whatever. I mean, it would have ruined everyone's brackets, but I think UCF would have been America's team. They would be the Dallas Cowboys of college basketball had they beat Duke.
All right, we'll take that.
I like it. Okay, so ready to do the hot topics?
Sure, let's do it. Here we go.
Hot topics.
A black bear is a prime suspect in a case of broken beehives and stolen honey in Pennsylvania.
Oh, no, look at him.
Yeah, there
he is. He's a hardened criminal.
The incident took place at a university research center. Officials discovered one of the three hives had been pulled apart and heavily licked. There were no witnesses, but the school says evidence points to a hungry black bear. So the university released this hilarious wanted poster for the suspected culprit. Meanwhile, the remaining hives are now being kept safe behind an electric fence. So try to get to that. Yogi.
Gosh. Okay. Anytime I think of a bee story, I think of our awesome meteorologist. A bee story.
Oh.
I kind of ran it together.
Anytime I think of a beast.
Anytime I think of a beast, I think of Tom Ackerman. No, I was going to say anytime we have a bee story, I think of Tom Ackerman, because as you guys know, he's a beekeeper, and I love when he posts updates on his social media and stuff.
What's the name for, what do they call themselves?
A bee man.
No, that's not
there is a name, and we talked about it once. Seth, will you look it up?
Is it apiology?
What does it mean? What does it mean?
Apes. They're apes.
They're apes. Tom is an ape.
Apiaries. Is that right?
You said it once, and I doubted you, and I don't know why I ever doubt you.
I don't know.
You'd have such random knowledge. Mm. Anyway, so.
Well, if we find out, we find out.
If we find out, we do. If not.
Not going to die over it.
No. Dr. Dre posted a picture to his Instagram page of his daughter, Truly Young, and her acceptance letter to the University of Southern California. Uh-oh. He wrote, "My daughter got accepted into USC all on her own. No jail time!" Exclamation point. Of course, it's a thinly veiled reference to dozens of parents now facing federal charges after accusations they lied and cheated to get their kids into prestigious schools, including USC. Many people, and of course, the two most known people that are caught up in this, Lori Loughlin and Felicity Huffman, actresses. Many people pointed out, though, in 2013, Dr. Dre and producer Jimmy Iovine donated $70 million to establish the Jimmy Iovine and Andre Young Academy for Arts Technology.
Jimmy Iovine, I think.
Oh, okay.
He used to be on American Idol.
Oh, okay. There's a random O in there. I wasn't sure how to
say it. Yeah, it's
weird. Okay. Anyway, donated a bunch of money. Dr. Dre has since deleted the post.
Again, somebody explain to me the wisdom in getting your kid into a school that doesn't want to go to school.
Yeah.
Again, Lori Loughlin's daughter was adamant about not wanting to learn anything.
After she was in college?
No.
It was before?
Before college.
Oh.
She was making several declarations on Twitter how she hated scholastic activity. Why would you? I mean, this is beyond stupid. It's beyond stupid.
Aunt Becky's going to jail.
Yeah.
It's not going to be good.
I don't know why they thought they'd get away with it.
I cannot wrap my head around that. Or Felicity could be going to prison.
President Donald Trump spent part of Saturday golfing with friends at his Florida resort. He had Kid Rock there. Posted this picture of the two. Look at those pants. Kid Rock is rocking.
God bless America.
Kid Rock thanked President Trump for another great day on the links and for being so down to earth and so fun to be with. The golf game came a day after the release of a special counsel report from Robert Mueller. President Trump has remained silent on Twitter and in official statement since Friday evening, which is a shock.
I know. I'm literally shocked he's been silent, because all along he said our favorite quote, "No collusion."
No collusion.
No collusion.
And now he's essentially, I don't want to say vindicated, but I mean, you know, Mueller report isn't what a lot of his enemies hoped it would be.
Yeah.
So you'd think he would really be spiking the ball in the end zone.
Yeah,
in
case you missed it, the Mueller report came out and said that they found the Trump campaign did not collude in any way with Russia to win the election. But yeah, I'm shocked that he hasn't tweeted anything. Also shocked at this tweet from Kid Rock. I just love how...
That would be a fun foursome to play in.
Yeah.
With those guys.
Who would be your fourth?
I don't know. Who could I add to that? Nancy Pelosi. let's just stir the pot and see what would happen.
I bet she'd be shockingly good at golf. She's got a lot of anger built up.
I don't know. There'd be so much tightness. You know... You wouldn't know.
In this region?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. She could express herself.
Am I playing golf or am I re-entering the Earth's atmosphere? I don't know.
Bless her heart.
Anyway, I just love Kid Rock's tweet, because what's cracking me up about it, it's just like so casual, as if that's not the President of the United States.
Yeah.
So fun to be with. It sounds like he's tweeting about one of his girlfriends.
And has anybody ever said anything about Donald Trump? He's down to earth?
I know. That's what
down
the tweet,
to
I'm
earth.
Like.
I mean, you could say, hey, he's courageous. Did he think he was posting that fight,
Yeah. Did he think he was posting that caption with a different photograph with someone else? And then
down
he's like, oh,
earth.
Shoot.
Yeah. You know that guy with the gold toilet? Down to earth.
Down to earth. Oh, my gosh.
That's
His butler
I
and I were just talking about it the other day. Mm-hmm. So lovely. Goodness. Right. Okay, those are today's hot topics.